So good morning, dear students. First of all, a very huge round of applause for Simran. All of you clap for Simran. We are so proud that Simran is a student of our class. Did you see that Kiran Bedi show yesterday? All of you, I sent you link also. I sent you screenshots also side by side. So you all have seen or not? Did you notice this thing that how confidently she was interacting with Dr. Kiran Bedi? How did she speak? I was feeling so proud that she is my student. Really, Simran, that's really well done. You have done. We are really proud of you and congratulations to you from whole class 9A. All of you, give your heartiest felicitation to Simran. Convey your wishes to her. How many of you have seen that show? Tell me honestly. How many of you have seen? Tell me. Raise your hands. Those who have seen that show. There are very less students. Okay, today you get time. You just check out your time and see that show. You will feel really proud that how Simran was participating, how she was interacting with that great personality. There is a link in English group also I have shared with you, and in 9A group also, class group. So you can watch it on Facebook also. You can watch it on YouTube also. It's on Twitter also. So wherever you feel comfortable, you can see that show. Then you will come to know about the achievement of Simran. Okay? Wait. So now we are going to do question answers of Happy Prince.
So yeah,
can you read the questions?
सब कुछ आ रहा है।
Get ready with the questions that we have to discuss today. So. So we were discussing short question answers, and question number fourth we have. Question number fourth we were discussing yesterday. What does the swallow see when it flies over the city? Yes, come on. So who is ready with this answer? Who is ready with this answer? Okay, I'm going to ask from offline students, then I will ask from online. Okay. So the swallow was able to see the miserable condition, misery of that city. That how were they living? There were people so poor that they were not even able to afford food. They were not having money to afford food. So such kind of miserable condition was seen by swallow. But you have to elaborate this answer in detail. So you tell me. Pranay, you show me your face. Pranay, you show me your face, then I will give you a chance to speak. Your face is not visible. You show me your face, Pranay. You are raising your hand because you have raised your hand first time in class. So it's better that you show me your face, then I will give you a chance to tell me the answer. Show me your face for a while. For a fraction of a second, yes. Now tell me this answer.
The swallow sees when it flies over the city that the rich people live in beautiful houses and beggar was sitting at the gates and they were so hungry. And the two little boys were under the bridge.
Okay. Clear. Now, any other student who wants to tell me fourth answer? Okay, Renuka from offline, you tell me. Okay, now let's move to question number 5. Question number 5 we have is, why did the swallow not leave the prince and go to Egypt? What was the reason? Because earlier swallow was so desperate, he was so eager to move to Egypt because his friends were waiting for him there. Every time he was saying, he was insisting, happy prince, that you just please let me go because my friends are waiting. But at last, he made up his mind that he did not want to go there. He wanted to stay with Happy Prince forever. So what was the reason behind that? What was the reason? So who is going to tell me this answer? Get ready with this answer, all of you. I can ask this answer from any of the child. So from offline class, you tell me, last girl, yes. Okay, so same answer, Arzu, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Since the prince had given away the two spheres of his eyes, he had become blind. Therefore, the swallow, he decided to stay with the prince always. The swallow, he was so touched by the prince's kindness that he decided to stay back rather than flying to Egypt and be with his friends.
Your 9th B has not joined here. Not even a single student from 9th B. Whose period was earlier this? मेरे बैग में से मोबाइल निकालना चाहिए। Okay. Simran, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The happy prince was such a jubilant and joyful person when he was alive, but after his death, the position where it was placed in the form of a statue, he was able to see all the misery and ugliness of his city. So that's when he decided to help. Even when his heart was made of lead, he was so innocent and pure from inside. The swallow was so happy and
Yes, your answer was good. Okay.
Ma'am, I haven't said the answer yet.
You just speak it again because I was busy on that call because there is a competition of two classes. So, tell me this answer again.
When the prince was alive, he was so jubilant and happy, but after his death, the place where he was placed in the form of a statue, he was able to see all the misery and ugliness of his city. That's when he decided to help. Even when his heart was made of lead, he was so innocent and pure from inside. The swallow was so impressed by the acts of kindness of the happy prince. Also, he saw that the prince lost both his eyes in the form of sapphires from which he helped the poor little girl and the playwright. So he decided not to move to Egypt and help the prince forever so that he will be his messenger and tell him whatever is happening in his city.
So your concluding lines were very good. Otherwise, whole of the answer is right. But the way she concluded that at last, after seeing the miserable condition of the city, after going, you can say, to the house of playwright, see the condition of that poor lady, okay, whose son was ill, after seeing the condition of mastic, and he thought that at last he made up his mind, he took a decision that he should act like a messenger of happy prince, and in this way he would be able to help all the needy people, poor people in this way. So that's why he thought that he should not move to Egypt, rather he should stay with happy prince, because now happy prince was not having eyes, because he has given both of his sapphires, one to playwright and second one to mastic girl. So that's why he was not able to see. So how would he come to know about the misery, about the miserable condition of the city if anybody was in, would be in the need? So that's why this decision was taken by him to stay with him forever. Okay. Now let's move to question number 6. What are the precious things mentioned in the story? Why are they precious? Why are they precious? Yes, you tell me. Okay, good. Same answer. So Dhiren, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The two most precious things mentioned in the chapter are the swallow, who was dead at the end because of cold and snow, and the second thing is the leaden broken heart of the prince. These two things are so precious to the god or the angel because of the dignity and the respect they showed to the city. When the prince was alive, he used to be happy, but after his death, he was put up as a statue and he gave all his things, a ruby in his sword, his two precious eyes as a sapphires to the playwright and the young match girl. And the second thing, the swallow was so happy to see the prince that he sacrificed everything for his city to make the people's condition better and thought to be the prince always and died for him.
Very nice. Good. So I expect this answer from now. Ikjot, you tell me this answer. Okay, who is going to tell me this answer? Who is going to tell me this answer? I asked Ikjot to tell me this answer. Yes, Ikjot.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, bachche, tell me what would be this answer. What are the precious things mentioned in the story and why are they precious? Why are they
the leader? The leader heart of the happy prince and the dead swallow are the two precious things mentioned in the story. They are precious as they did various deeds for the welfare of people and sacrificed their lives for sake of others.
Okay, good. Jayati, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The two most precious things mentioned in the story are the leaden heart of the happy prince and the dead bird. They both are precious because they both were full of compassion, sympathy, and kindness. They sacrificed their life to help others. The prince became very sad to see the miseries of the city, and the swallow became his messengers to help others. So the God chosen them as the precious things.
God chose them. Okay. So very, very beautifully described that which were the two beautiful things, the leaden heart of happy prince and dead body of that swallow, both were considered as the most precious things. Why they were considered precious things? Because they had a beautiful heart. They were full of compassion, sympathy, kindness. Yes, they sacrificed their life for the sake of others. So that's why God considered those two things the most precious and beautiful things. And they were given place where? They were given the place in the paradise. They were given the place in paradise. Okay? Now talk about it, this question. The little swallow says it is curious, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold. Have you ever had such a feeling? Share your experience with your friend. See, when we do a good task, we feel contented. We feel satisfied. We have a, you can say, sense of contentment in our heart. We feel so relaxed and so lighthearted when we do good to others without thinking about this thing that after doing this thing, what we are going to get. Sometimes it happens with us. Sometimes we help others, but in place of that, we don't get anything. But internally, we feel satisfied. So this is a gesture of kindness. Okay? Charity, kindness, generosity. So do you think that you have done such kind of task in your life? Because in this chapter, when earlier swallow was so desperate to meet his friends, he wanted to go there. But when happy prince told him that, no, please do me this task, you become my messenger and do this task, and he was ready. Okay? And when he helped that lady, and when he came back, what dialogue did he speak? He spoke that, no doubt, it is so chilly winter. It is so cold. But he is feeling so warm. Why? Because there was a sense of contentment. There was a sense of satisfaction. Because at that time, he was feeling generous. He was feeling so kind that he had done a task without getting anything in back, in reverse of that, without getting anything in back. So he was feeling warm inside. So at that chilly winter, he was not feeling cold. So here the question is that, why I'm explaining that? Because so that you can understand what is the meaning of that question, that do you have such kind of feelings in your life ever? You just share your experience in class, that have you ever got a chance to help others? And you have helped them. And after that, you slept so soundly. You were feeling so lighthearted. You were feeling so relaxed. You just share your experience in this class. And you have to be very much honest for this answer. Don't make a false story. I don't want to listen to this kind of story. You just tell me truth. So who is going to tell me this truth? Anybody from offline class or online class, raise your hands. Okay, Ridhima.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, Ridhima, you tell me this.
First of all, man is a social animal. He is social because he is dependent on
Keep
others.
Keep your camera on.
Okay, ma'am. Man is a social animal. He is social because he is dependent on. Ma'am, you have tell to keep now it off or on?
Now it is on. Now you speak.
Man is a social animal. He is social because he is dependent on others to lead a satisfactory life. In this regard, mutual help is required whenever we help others. I have shared this same feeling with me. Once I saw a poor girl standing outside my home, and she was asking door to door to have for our help, and no one is giving her food. I offered her food and water, and she really smiled at me and said thank you in English, and she said you are really kind. I feel so happy that day because I helped a little girl, and I gave her just simply a food that my mother cooked for me and my family, and some little bit part of it I gave to her, and she made her day with full of happiness, and she's full with her tummy, and she told thank you to me, and that was really a big type of good gesture to from her to me.
So after providing help to that girl, how did you feel internally? Did you sleep soundly?
Yeah, very, very, very. I feel very like I have a helper.
You were feeling like a bird? So lighthearted?
Yeah.
Your mind was so relaxed? So that's nice.
Yeah.
Now I expect this answer from Simran.
Yes, ma'am. Whenever human help others, they feel satisfaction. It's an internal satisfaction. Our heart feels contented and we feel all relaxed, and our mind is so on a relaxation mode that we helped someone. We feel warm from inside, like we, our internal soul is hugging our body from inside. And same happened with me, like the little swallow. Little swallow showed act of selfless service with utmost dedication, and that's why in the story it's the most precious. And in my life, in reality, I whenever I even see an ant struggling to get out, I just help that ant. And even at that little good gesture made by me, all night I sleep so soundly and I feel so good that I helped someone. The day I started helping, when I started getting mature, I learned that we should help others. I feel presence of God around me. I think that God is watching me. I shouldn't swear. I shouldn't say bad words to anyone. And I always try to help every needy person I see. So that's the day when I realized that all humans have pure heart. Only we need to realize that we have a kind heart. We need to help others. Thank you.
Very good. Very nice. Very nice. Now from 9th B, who wants to tell me this answer? Pritika, do you know the answer? Raise your hands. Sumati, you tell me this answer. From 9th A. Sumati, do you have experience in this field? Sumati is not responding. I think after logging in, they go somewhere. Arzu, do you have experience in this field? Have you ever helped anybody? Arzu, have you ever helped anybody? It means Arzu has also gone somewhere after logging in. Daljeet, do you have experience in this field? Daljeet, Am I audible? I have asked three students that they are not responding, and three are good. Daljeet is not responding. Arzu is not responding. Sumati is not responding. It means they have logged in, but they are not present in class. So they will be marked absent today. Arzu, Daljeet also. From 9th B, Archita, can you tell me this answer? Archita or Kritika? Can you tell me this answer? I just share question with you. This is a question that we are discussing. The little swallow says it is curious, but I feel quite warm now. Although it is so cold. Have you ever had such a feeling? Share your experience with your friends. From offline class. From offline class. Vatsal, you tell me this answer. You share your experience when you helped somebody. Pranay, why are you doing annotation on my screen? Pranay, why are you doing annotation? Tell me, you don't have experience. You haven't helped anybody. Okay, you tell me. Your name is? Lovelina is going to share her experience.
To have lunch. Once I went to McDonald's to have lunch with my family. When I sat down to have my meal, I saw a boy staring at everyone's food. Everyone was seeing aggressively toward him as he was staring on their food. And when I saw that boy, I understood his condition, that he was starving from hunger. I immediately got up and left my food in between and bought a happy meal for him and went to him. And gave that meal to him. When he took that meal from me, he was very happy, and I felt a feeling of relaxation. And I was contented when I gave food to him. I was feeling very relaxed and contented.
Now another girl, she wants to Divya. Diya, she wants to tell about her experience in this field.
The day we went to an official building and there was a lady who did not know how to read or write. She was asking for help, but everyone was busy with their own forms. I addressed it and helped her complete her form. She was very happy and the smile made my day.
So she concluded this answer in a very nice way, that how did she help that girl, and that smile made her day. Because when you help somebody and that person gives you a smile, so this smile is equal to 100 millions. You can say that there is no, you can say, comparison with that smile. So that smile can make your day, that can make you more happier. That can make you happier as compared to that person, because that person would be very much happy to whom you would give help. But the person who gives that help, I think that person would be happier one. Okay. So any other student who wants to share their experience? That is a very good question. You have to share your experience here. You can tell.
one day I went somewhere and I saw a girl who was very small, and there was a water shortage in their area. So she was taking a bucket full of water towards their to her house, and she was not able to hold that bucket of water. So I helped that girl by holding that bucket of water, and took that bucket of water in her house, and her smile made my day. She smiled very beautifully.
So these all were beautiful gestures which were shared by my good students. Okay, students, now your syllabus is over. From Monday onwards, we are going to start revision. Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day.